بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Back with the author, may Allah have mercy upon him. He says Faslun section, and Sheikh Mansour Saqayub, he says هذا الفصل عقده المؤلف لبيان من لا يجزئ دفع الزكاة إليهم وتكلم في الفصل أيضا عن صدقة التطوع. Sheikh Mansour explaining the introduction here, he's saying that this section was authored or put together by the author to make clear that those categories whom zakat is not going to be permissible for. And also he talks in this section regarding those issues pertaining to voluntary charity. الزكاه لا يجوز دفعها لاصناف من الناس لاصناف من الناس. Charity, zakat, is not allowed to be given to a variety of people, and they are as follows. The first of them, آل النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, the family of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. وهم بنو حاشم, and they are the tribe of حاشم. وبنو مطلب, أخو حاشم. And بنو مطلب, the tribe of حاشم, who are the brothers. بنو مطلب, the tribe of مطلب, who are the brothers of حاشم. وأبناء عبد مناف, and the sons of عبد مناف. والدليل, and the evidence for this, this exception, that zakah is not given to these families of the Prophet ﷺ, أم بنو حاشم فهم آل محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم. That بنو حاشم, they are the family of the Prophet ﷺ. And in Bukhari and Muslim, from the hadith of Abu Hurairah رضي الله عنه, قال أخذ الحسن ابن علي تمرة من تمر صدقة. That Hassan رضي الله عنه, the son of Ali رضي الله عنه, he took a date from the dates of صدقة. فجعلها في فيه, and he put it in his mouth. فَقَالَ رَسُولُ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said, خِقْ خِقْ, and he made a noise to grab his attention. إِرْمِي بِهَا, he said, throw that away. أَمَّا عَلِمْتَ أَنَّ لَا نَأْكُلُ صَدَقَةً, don't you know that we don't eat from the sadaqah, we don't eat from zakah or from non-obligatory charity. وَأَمَّا بَنُ مُطَلِبْ فَلِيَنَّ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم جعلهم شرك يشاركون بني حاشم في الخمس. As for بنو مطلب, the tribe of مطلب, they also cannot take from the sadaqa, because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم made them يشاركون. He made them صلى الله عليه وسلم join with بني حاشم in taking the خمس. The خمس is the war booty. لما جاءه رجال من بني عبد الشمس يكلمونه في هذا قال لهم. And when people came to him from بني عبد الشمس speaking to him about this matter, the Prophet ﷺ said, إِنَّمَا بَنُ مُطَّلِبْ وَبَنُ حَاشِمْ شَيْءٌ وَاحِدٌ. That verily, بَنُ مُطَّلِبْ, the tribe of مُطَّلِبْ, and the tribe of حَاشِمْ are one thing. And this hadith is in Bukhari and Muslim. There's a second riwayah in the madhab, another narration in the madhab from Ahmed, أَنَّهُمْ بَنُ حَاشِمْ فَقَطْ وَلَا يَدْخُلُ فِيهِمْ بَنُ مُطَّلِبْ. That it's only بَنُ حَاشِمْ that are not allowed to take from the sadaqah, but بَنُ مُطَّلِبْ are allowed to take from that. And from the ones who held this was the companion of was Imam al-Khiraqi, the Imam of the Madhab, and Ibn Qudama, and Majd ibn Taymiyyah, and Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah himself. The author, he says, وَمَوَالِيهِمَا, and also who cannot take from sadaqah are those who are the freed slaves of these tribes and now have become bondsmen of this tribe. لا تدفع الزكاة لموالي بني حاشم وكذا لموالي بني مطلب. So zakat is not given to the tribe, to the freed slaves, the bondsmen of Bani Hashim, nor to the bondsmen of Bani Muttalib. And the hadith is found in Ahmad and Abi Dawood from Abi Rafi' radiallahu anhu. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam قال قال له حينما أراد الذهاب لسعي في جبالة الزكاة. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said to Abi Rafi' when he wanted to go along with the collectors of the zakah, he said, "Mawla al-qawm min anfusihim, wa inna la tahillu lana sadqa." He said that the mawla, the freed slaves of a people, their bondsmen, are from them, and it's not permissible for us, this tribe, to have sadqa, to have from the zakah. The author, he also says, and as an exception to those who should not take the zakah or who cannot take the zakah, is as follows. وَلَا إِلَى فَقِيرَةٍ تَحْتَ غَنِيٍّ مُنْفِقٍ. Nor can a female who is poor, she's faqir, nor can she take zakah if she is under the responsibility of somebody who is rich and spending. إِذَا كَانَ إِنْدَنَا إِمْرَأَةٌ فَقِيرًا مُتَزَوِّجًا. So if we have, for example, a woman who is married, but she's very poor, فَإِنَّهَا لَا تُؤْتَ مِنَ الزَّكَاءِ إِذَا تَحَقَّقَ فِيهَا وَصْفًا. Then this woman is not given from the zakah if two descriptions are found in her. The first of them, أَن تَكُونَ تَحْتَ غَنِيٍّ. The first of them is that she is under the care of somebody who is rich, from her relatives, husband, etc. The second of them, أَن يَكُونَ الْغَنِيِّ مُنْفِقًا بَاذِنًا. The second of these descriptions found in this woman who should not take the zakah is that the one that is responsible for her, this rich person, is actually spending upon her. وَالْإِلَّا. And the reason for this, أَنَّهَا فِي الْحَقِيقَةِ لَيْسَتْ فَقِيرًا. That in reality, she is not poor. لِأَنَّ زَوْجُهَا يُنْفِقُ عَلَيْهَا فَقَدْ اسْتَغْنَتْ. Because her husband, or the one responsible for her, will spend upon her, so she is taking care of her needs. She is considered as being rich. ومفهوم ذلك, and the understanding from this, أنه إذا تخلف أحد الوصفين جاز إعطاؤها من الزكاة. That if one of these two factors which I mentioned are absent from this woman, meaning that she is not being taken care of by a rich person, then it is permissible for زكاة to be given to her. The author, he says, ولا إلى فرعه وأصله. Nor can زكاة be given to the فرع of the person, nor the أصل of the person. The asl is al-aba, the asl is the fathers. Wa in alu, even if they go up higher, like for example, the father, the grandfather, the great-grandfather. These, they cannot take zakah. Wal ummahat, and the mothers, and the grandmother, and the grandmothers. Okay? And the far, who cannot take zakah, are the abna'uhu, are the sons and daughters, the children. They cannot take zakah either, whether they are grandchildren or great-grandchildren. Wal illa, and the reason, أَنَّهُ تَجِبُ عَلَيْهِ وَتَلْزِمُهُ نَفَقَتَهُمْ. Because the one who is giving zakah, he has a responsibility to take care of the needs of these people that have been mentioned. Okay, that's why he cannot give zakah to them. وَهَذَا الْحُكْمُ بِالْإِجْمَاءِ. And this hukum is a bil-ijma'. Because if he was to give zakah to them, it's as though he is removing the responsibility of spending upon them from himself. So the benefit comes back to him of the zakah. That's why it's not allowed. قوله, the مؤلف, the author, may Allah have mercy upon him, he says, ولا إلى عبد. And nor is it permissible to give to a slave. Question to yourselves to keep us awake. Why is it not permissible to give zakah to a slave? Hasan, barakallahu feek. So that's part of the answer, that the slave doesn't have wealth which belongs to him. Rather, everything that he owns belongs to the master. And as you said, he's the responsibility of the master. So the ulama, they say, أَنَّ نَفَقَتُهُمْ وَاجِبَةٌ عَلَى سَيِّدِهِ. That his nafaqah, his spending, to spend upon the slave, is obligatory upon the master. Okay? وَلِأَنَّنَا لَأَعْطَيْنَاهُ لَنْتَقَلَ الْمَالِ لِسَيِّدِهِ فَوْرًا. And if we were to give to the slave zakah, then that money would immediately go to the master instead, because the master is the one who is in possession of the money of the slave. فَإِنَّ الْمَالَ الْعَبْدِ مَالٌ لِسَيِّدِهِ. For verily the wealth of the slave is the wealth of his master. And also, the author, he mentions, was zawj, meaning the husband. Actually, in Arabic, zawj can mean husband or wife. So he says, was zawj. لا يجوز لزوج أن يدفع زكاته لزوجته. It's not permissible for the husband to give zakah to his wife. والعلة, and the reason for this ruling, أن نفقتها واجبة عليه. Because the spending upon the wife for her basic needs and above is obligatory upon the husband. فَلَا يُدْفَعَ زَكَاتُهُ فِيمَا وَجِبَ عَلَيْهِ الْإِنْفَاقِ فِيهِ. So he's not allowed to give zakah for that which he is already obligated to be spending upon. وَكَذَأَ الزَّوْجَ لَا يَصِحُّ أَن تَدْفَعَ زَكَاءَ مَا لَهَا لِزَوْجِهَا. بَارَكَ اللَّهُ فِيكَ. Can we have the kids on silent? جَزَاكَ اللَّهُ خَيْرٌ. وَكَذَأَ الزَّوْجَ لَا يَصِحُّ أَن تَدْفَعَ زَكَاءَ مَا لَهَا لِزَوْجِهَا. Also, a woman, if she has a poor husband, she's not allowed to give from her zakah to the husband who is poor. وَالْعِلَّ, and the reason behind that, أَنَّهَا تَنْتَفِعْ بِدَفْئِهَا إِلَيْهِ. Because she is the one who ends up benefiting from that zakat wealth. فَمَا يَأْخُذُ زَوْجْ يَعُودُ نَفْعُهُ عَلَى زَوْجَ. So whatever the husband is taking from the zakah from her, it's going to return to her in benefit. فَتَكُونُ قَدْ تَوَسَّعَتْ بِزَكَاتِهَا. الرواية الثانية عن أحمد, another riwayah from Imam Ahmad, another narration on this issue from your Imam Ahmed. أنه يجوز دفعها له إذا كان من أهل الزكاة. That the wife, she can give. أنه يجوز دفعها له. نعم. That the wife, she can give to the poor husband if he's from the people of Zakah, meaning he's miskeen or he's poor, etc. لكنه لا يصرف من ذلك في الإنفاق عليها. But it's not allowed for him to use that zakat money which has been given to him from his wife to be then spent on the wife's needs. That is not allowed. And Ibn Qudama, Imam Ibn Qudama rahimahullah ta'ala, was from those who held this opinion. The author, he says, وَإِنْ أَعْطَاهَا لِمَنْ ظَنَّهُ غَيْرَ أَهْلٍ فَبَانَ أَهْلًا. If the one who is giving zakat gives it to a person that he thinks before giving it that this person doesn't deserve the zakat. I know a very strange scenario, who would do that? So the person, the author is saying, if a person gives zakat and he thinks that this person doesn't deserve zakat, but then he ends up being from those who do deserve zakat, أو بالعكس, or the opposite in this scenario, لم يجزئه, then his zakat is not going to be valid. So Sheikh Mansour, he says, هنا مسألتان. Here we have two مسألة, we have two issues. الأولى, لو أنه دفع زكاة لمن اعتقد أنه غير أهل الزكاة فتبين أنه أهل لها فإنها لا تزئ. والإلا أنه متلاعب مفرط في دفعها. So as we explained, if a person in the first issue is giving زكاة to a person that in his mind and from his estimation, he believes that this person doesn't deserve زكاة. So he gives zakat to that person, but then the person ends up being someone who did deserve zakat. Then in this situation, the zakat is not valid. Why? Because from the outset, the person is playing with the religion. This is not how we treat the religion of Allah Azza wa Jal. How dare somebody give zakat to a category that he in his mind thinks that they are not deserving of the zakat. Okay? Now, وَالثَّانِيَا, and the second scenario, the opposite, إذا دفع زكاة لمن ظن أنه مستحق للزكاة فتبين أنه ليس أهلا لها فلا تجزئه. So if a person is giving zakat to a person and he thinks that this person is somebody who deserves to take zakat, is deserving of taking zakat, but then it turns out that the person actually wasn't from those categories who zakat can be paid to, so in this situation the zakat is not going to be valid. والعلة, and the reasoning, أنه دفعها لغير مستحقها, because he paid it to somebody who did not deserve it. والعبرة بما في النفس الأمر لا بما ظن. And the reality of the ruling, the reality of the situation, is that which is the reality and not that which he thought to be. So the ruling is based upon the reality of the situation, not that which he thought it to be. Now there's an exception to this ruling that we just mentioned. إلا لغني ظنه فقير. The exception is that if he gave his zakah to a person thinking and estimating that this person is poor, but then he turned out to be rich, so this person, in this situation, the zakah is going to be accepted. So Sheikh Mansour, he said, لو أن رجلا عليه علامات الفقر فظنه فقير. So this person has the outward appearance of being a poor person. وسأل زكاة فعطاه. So this person asked for zakat, and the one who was distributing the zakat gave it to him. فَتَبَيَّنَ أَنَّهُ غَنِيٍّ فَإِنَّهُ يُجْزِئُ. But then it became known later that this person is actually rich. He wasn't poor as you thought. So in this situation, the zakat is still going to be valid. Why? One of the evidences they use is in Sahih Muslim, the hadith of Abi Hurairah radiallahu anhu, قَالَ رَجُلًا لَأَتَصَدَّقَنَّ اللَّيْلَ بِصَدَقَةٍ أَمَانٍ. He made a vow to himself that he's going to give zakat, or he's going to give charity in the way of Allah. فَخَرَجَ بِصَدَقَتِهِ فَوَضَعَهَا فِي يَدِّ زَانِيَةٍ. So he went out in the night and he gave sadaqah, but it ended up being in the hands of one who was a zaniya, one who was a prostitute. فَأَصْبَحُوا يَتَحَدَّثُونَ. But then the people, they woke up the next day, they found out the reality of the matter that the sadaqah was given to a prostitute, and they started to talk about it. Okay, and then the same thing happened, that he gave sadaqah to a rich man by mistake, right, in the night. And then the same thing happened, that he gave sadaqah to a poor, to a thief. Okay, and the people again in each situation, they got up and they spoke about it. فَأُوتِيَ فَقِيلَ لَهُ. So it came to him in the night, a dream or something of that nature. أَمَّا صَدَقَتُكَ فَقَدْ قُبِلَتْ. As for your sadaqah, it has been accepted from you. So in this hadith, one of the categories that sadaqah was given to in the night by mistake was to a rich person. So the ulama, they take from this hadith and other evidences that if sadaqah is given to a rich person by mistake, meaning to say that you spent your mental abilities, your faculties, and you looked at the situation of the person, you assumed him to be poor, but in fact it turned out later that he was not poor, he was rich, then your zakah is still going to be valid. The author, he says, وَصَدَقَةُ التَّطَوَّعِ مُسْتَحَبَّةٌ, and to give recommended charity, not obligatory charity, yani outside of zakah, to give recommended charity is something which is recommended, it's mustahab. طيب, أَنَّ صَدَقَةَ التَّطَوَّعَ قَدْ وَرَدَ فِي الْحَثِّ عَلَيْهَا آثَارٌ كَثِيرًا مِنَ الْكِتَابِ وَالسُنَّةِ. To give sadaqah, recommended sadaqah, there's many narrations which encourage people to do this. And there's many ayat in the Quran. From them is what is we found in Surah Al-Baqarah. مَنْ ذَا الَّذِي يُقْرِضُ اللَّهَ قَرْضًا حَسَنًا فَيُضَاعِفَهُ لَهُ أَضْعَافًا كَثِيرًا. Who is there that is going to give Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala a goodly loan, and then he will increase this loan for the person in reward many fold. We have in the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim, narrated by Abu Hurairah radiyallahu anhu, and the hadith is marfu', that the Prophet ﷺ said, مَنْ تَصَدَّقَ بِعَدْلِ تَمْرَةٍ مِنْ كَسْبٍ طَيِّبٍ. Whoever gives sadaqah, meaning not obligatory sadaqah, to the equivalence of a date, and this is from pure sources, he's earned this from pure sources, وَلَا يَقْبَلَ اللَّهُ إِلَّا طَيِّبٍ, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't accept except for that which is pure. فَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَتَقَبُّلُهَا بِيَمِينِهِ. For verily Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take this date in charity which was given with his right hand subhanahu wa ta'ala. ثُمَّ يُرَبِّيهَا لِصَاحِبِهِ, and Allah will cause it to grow huge in reward. كَمَّ يُرَبِّي أَحَدُكُمْ فَلُوَّهُ, as one of you allows your baby camel to grow. حَتَّى تَكُونَ مِثْلَ الْجَبَلِ, until it is like in reward to the extent of a mountain. So that is from some of the evidences which pertain to the encouragement to give non-obligatory charity. The author, he says, وَفِي رَمَضَانِ وَأَوْقَاتِ الْحَاجَاتِ أَفْضَلِ, that non-obligatory charity in Ramadan and in times of need is best, is better. أَصَدَقَةٌ مُسْتَحَبَّةٌ مُطْلَقًا. Sheikh Mansour says, صَدَقَةٌ is يعني مستحب, it's recommended in all times. لَكِنْ يَتَأَكَّدْ إِسْتِحْبَابِهَا وَيُعْظَمْ ثَوَابُهَا فِي مَوَادِعِ, but its istihbab is more certain or more encouraged, and its reward is greater in certain situations. The first of them he mentions, فِي الْأَزْمِنَةِ فِي الْأَزْمِنَةَ الشَّرِيفَةِ فِي الْأَزْمِنَةَ الشَّرِيفَةِ, in times when the Sharia has looked upon this time or this place as being honorable. كَرَمَضَان, like Ramadan. لِأَنَّ النَّبِي صلى الله عليه وسلم كَانَ أَجْوَدَ مَا يَكُونَ فِي رَمَضَان, because the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم was the most generous that he could ever be in the month of Ramadan. وَفِي عَشْرِ ذِي الْحِجَّةِ, and also in the 10 days of ذُو الْحِجَّةِ. The second is فِي أَوْقَاتِ الْحَاجَاتِ, when sadaqah is more recommended in times of difficulty and need. كَوَقْتِ الْمُجَاعَةِ وَالْفَقْرِ وَنَحْوِهَا, like in a time of muja'a, in a time of drought, or in great poverty, and that like it. فَهِيَ أَفْضَلْ مِنْ غَيْرِهَا, so it is better in these times than outside of these times. وَقَدْ قَالَ اللَّهُ تَعَالَى, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in the Quran, أَوْ إِطْعَامٌ فِي يَوْمٍ ذِي مَسْغَابَ, or to give, Allah says, and to give food in a day of the مَسْغَابَ. And Ibn Abbas radiallahu anhuma, he said, ذِي مَسْغَبَ أي ذِي مُجَاعَ. ذِي مَسْغَبَ is a day or is a time when there is widespread drought and poverty. وَقَالَ النَّخَعِي, and Imam al-Nakhai, he says, فِي يَوْمٍ أَطْعَامُ فِيهِ عَزِيزٍ, in a time when food is scarcely available and it's become very, it's become a commodity which is very valuable. So in these times, it's recommended to give sadaqah even more so than normal times. The author, he says, وَتُسَنُّ بِالْفَاضِلِ عَنْ كِفَايَتِهِ وَمَنْ يَمُنُهُ, and it's sunnah to give that which is above the person's needs and the needs of those whom he spends upon. Sheikh Mansour, he said, إِذَا وَجَدَ عِنْدَ الْإِنسَانِ نَفَقَةً تَكْفِيهِ وَتَكْفِي مَنْ يَمُونُهُ عَلَى الدَّوَامِ. So if a person finds that he has an income which suffices himself and suffices those that he's taking care of in a continual manner, meaning that this money that is coming to him is continual. كَمُتَّجِرْ, like he has a trade, for example. أو صَنْعَ, or he has a skill which brings him money. أو رواتب, or he has salary that is coming continually. أو وقف, or he has an endowment. ونحوي, and that which is like it. فَإِنَّهُمْ يَسَمُّ أَنْ يُنْفِقْ مَا فَضَّلَ عَنْ كِفَايَتِهِ. Yeah. So it's recommended for him in this situation where he has the continuous stream of income to spend from that which is beyond his needs. Once his needs are covered, it's recommended for him then to spend on others. In Bukhari, we have the hadith which alludes to this. خَيْرُ صَدَقَةِ مَا كَانَ عَنْ ذَهْرِ غِنَى. That the best of sadaqah is that which is عَنْ ذَهْرِ غِنَى. Sheikh Mansouri explains this. He says, أَنَّ الْأَفْضَلَ صَدَقَى مَا بَقِيَ صَاحِبُهَا بَعْدَ إِخْرَاجِهَا مُسْتَغْنِيًا. That the best sadaqah is that which is spent whilst the person who is spending it remains in a state of, in a good financial state. A. بَقِيَ لَهُ مَا يَكْفِيهِ وَيُغْنِيهِ فِي حَوَائِجِهِ وَمَصَالِحِهِ. So he has enough wealth remaining with him to cover his needs and the needs of those who he's taking care of. So in this situation, sadaqah is recommended and it's sunnah to give. The author, he says, وَيَأْثَمُ بِمَا يَنْقُصُهَا. And he is sinful, the person giving sadaqah, if it puts him in a situation where he is going to have needs. He's not going to be able to cover his basic needs, nor the basic needs of his family. So in this situation, it would be sinful for him. Sheikh Mansour, he said, إِذَا تَصَدَّقَ بِصَدَقَةٍ تَنْقُصُ كِفَايَتِهِ وَكِفَايَةِ مَنْ يَمُونُهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ يَأْثَمُ. So as I explained, that if he gives sadaqah and it ends up him being in a situation where he can't cover his needs, nor can he cover the needs of his family, the ones he takes care of, then in this situation, he is sinful. وَإِلَّا. And the reason is, أَنَ النَّفَقَ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ وَعَلَى مَنْ يَعُولُ وَاجِبًا. Because it's obligatory for him to cover his needs and to cover the needs of the ones that he's taking care of. فَلَا يُقَدِّمْ عَلَيْهَا مَا هُوَ تَطَوَّعُ. So the supererogatory charity shouldn't be put before the wajib, which is to take care of his needs. وَقَدْ وَرَدَ فِي مُسْنَدِ Imam Ahmad. And Imam Ahmad, he narrates a hadith from the Prophet ﷺ, who said, كَفَى بِالْمَرْءِ إِثْمًا أَنْ يُضَيِّعَ مَنْ يَقُوتُ. It's enough as a sin for a person that he loses the rights of the one that he's taking care of, or he loses the ability from his own doing to take care of those who he's supposed to take care of. وَلِأَنَّ أَفْضَلَ صَدَقَى مَا يُنْفِقُهُ الْإِنسَانِ عَلَى نَفْسِهِ. And because the best sadaqah is the one that a person spends upon himself, وَعَلَى مَنْ يَعُولُ, and upon his family that he's taking care of. In Sahih Muslim, the Prophet ﷺ said, دِنَارٌ أَنْفَقْتَهُ فِي سَبِيلِ اللَّهِ. A dinar that you spend as charity in the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. وَالدِنَارٌ أَنْفَقْتَهُ فِي رَقَبَةٍ. And a dinar that you spend in charity to free a slave. وَالدِنَارٌ تَصَدَّقْتَ بِهِ عَلَى مِسْكِينٍ. And a dinar that you spend upon a miskin. وَالدِنَارٌ أَنْفَقْتَهُ عَلَى أَهْلِكَ. And a dinar that you spend upon your family. أَعْظَمُهَا أَجْرًا. That the greatest in terms of reward from those categories, الَّذِي أَنْفَقْتَهُ عَلَى أَهْلِكَ, is that which you spent upon your family in charity. Okay? So this is all going back to show us what the author, he said, that we shouldn't spend in charity unless we are able to cover the needs of ourselves and the needs of our families. And with that, and the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we come to the end of the book of Zakah. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to give us the best of understanding and to forgive us all mistakes.